So, looking at recommended reading lists. Now, these are based on autobiographies, non-technology, basically business. So, we're talking about focusing on business autobiographies, but here focus is non-technology. I've made a separate list for technology because with Apple and Google and so many people coming, Dell, HP, the technology has become the in thing. But these are good recommended books for non-technology. It's a very interesting read. I mean, autobiographies obviously is a story of a person. How did he build up his whole business and went about becoming good? And that's what is quite inspirational for a lot of people who want to read it. So, Shoe Dog by Phil. I read this book recently and quite interesting. It's basically the Nike brand. So, which Phil Knight went about starting and making it big. How did it go? What did it go? Quite interesting read. Made in America is a little older book. I remember reading it quite some time back. But amazing read. I mean, you feel like, I mean, a person who started from nowhere and start creating the whole Walmart brand is like amazing from nowhere to make it big. So that inspires you to think big. And these are very good books to read. So these are two books which I feel are the best among this lot. Straight from the Gut is more of a, you know, guy who is gone to become a CEO and not of an entrepreneur sort of thing, but person who is a boss. Like, he's supposed to be one of the best bosses across the world, head of GE and taking a lot of great decisions. So this is about him as to how did he go about doing, you know, becoming a good boss. Ayakoka, I mean, car industry, he's well known in that, starting with, you know, Ford cars and Chrysler and doing really well. So it's also a very inspirational story which talks to you about inside of a business, what happens in the whole spectrum of business, and becomes quite interesting. Warren Buffett is a well-known, I've not read this book, but knowing Warren Buffett, it's one of the bestseller lists, I felt that this book had to be in the list. So anyone who looks up to Warren Buffett, his simplistic ideas and the way he goes, I'm sure his well-known idea about how did he start from when he was 10, 11 years old? All these people started quite late. I mean, Sam Walton, etc. started when they were very, you know, middle age, etc. Warren Buffett started when he was 11. Imagine. How did he go about thinking, believing, going up his ideas, and being one of the richest person in the world? So all these books are good. So we'll go to each of these books and try to figure out what. But this is a brief list of the books that you can read, and they're all interesting. Shoe Dog by Phil Knight. As I said, it is how did he go about starting his particular business. A particular person who, you know, had nothing with him. I mean, he was interested in shoes. Went about starting making the shoes. And that's how he went about becoming. So we talked about different things. How did he go to Japan? How did he go across the world? Try to start a business. The whole hardship that he faced. The whole frustrations. All that is described so well out here. And it tells you that it's starting a business is not a very easy thing to do. I mean, today we see Nike, we look at things like, oh, wow, what one of the biggest business and he's a billionaire. But from where did he start? How did he go about starting? Everything is described so well that you just feel it that, okay, you are in that whole story. You'd want to be in a challenge. And how did he face right from being really frustrated to maybe being ecstatic to what he's done? I love this book. So it is a very inspiring in terms of how to go about it, talking about strategies and etc. It was about Sam Walton who went about starting the whole Walmart story, and he started when he was 45 years old. Imagine, I mean, so old after he has completed his. So we know the story of KFC. That guy started after 66 or 60, after 60 plus years. So no, but still, Walmart starting the whole, you know, Walmart story at 45 is like amazing. The way he had to work hard and start his whole business. I think they're all inspirations. And I think people who really should read this book, because it creates a lot of inspiration, not only maybe forget starting the business, but to work hard to achieve your goals. That is what is important. Jack Welch is known as, you know, a badass boss, toughest boss, you can say. So MG is a very widespread business into different kind of business, etc. He was outsider who went about heading the business and doing amazing things to help G grow rapidly. So the whole decision making skills of a CEO, etc., you can look at it. He was also one person who was not very for technology. So he didn't embrace technology till very late when he realized that technology can make a difference. Yeah, but G is a very widespread business, and the way he went about heading it, is a good story to read. And it's again an inspirational thing. So again, not an entrepreneur, but a person who went about working for different business, starting Ford, Chrysler, etc., and making a lot of difference in the automobile industry. Again, a good read, one of the earliest autobiographies of business world. It helps to keep it. It is quite interesting. I mean, you feel the whole story going about it. There are autobiographies which are there, which may not be very interesting, but yes, these are quite interesting reads. Warren Buffett, as I said, I've not read this book. I want to read this book. The fact that it is Buffett is what I kept the book. It is one of the best read books as such. So if I put it out here, so number one, New York bestsellers. Warren Buffett is known for his financial acumen, the way he thinks. Any financial guy should know about Warren Buffett. I mean, the way he thinks is amazing. Very simplistic nature. Anyone can understand it. A long-term investor. And by his simple ideas, he has made amazing amount of money. He's one of the richest person in the world and done really well with regards to it. So knowing him, and if you're looking at specializing in finance, you should know about Warren Buffett. It creates an edge just to know about him. So read it, and I think sure it'll help. So these are books which I would recommend to read. The first two books, definite. If you have a time, do read it. But the other books are also very good. Thank you.